What's up, everyone? Happy Easter. It's a great day out today. It's about 65 degrees. I'm here at Detweiler Marina, and I'm about to try out my mud motor on my canoe, round two. First time I did it, it was early February, and it was freezing, and it didn't go so well. It was just sketchy with the cold and everything. So much weight on the back of the canoe. So it's a 212cc Predator motor from Harbor Freight, matched with a Mudskipper longtail motor. It's pretty badass setup. There was a little water coming over the back last time. I didn't have enough weight in the front, and I'm a little more prepared this time. I've also kind of jerry-rigged the system, toe strap in the back over the handle to keep the motor from falling down when I let go of the throttle. That's one of the things I don't really love about this motor is if you don't have your hand on the motor lifting it up, as soon as you let go, that thing's gonna go to whatever depth the water is. It's gonna go straight up and down if you're in 6 feet of water as long as the tail. So that's kind of like a shortfall of this motor. I'm not sure why it's built that way, but I'm sure there's a reason. But I've seen some guys on YouTube do it that way with the straps, so we're gonna try it out. This is the rig here. It's pretty nice. Everything fits in my car. Got the 6.5-inch prop, wedge prop. Motor fits in there pretty easy. There's the mount. Whole motor probably weighs 65-70 pounds, I'm guessing. It's pretty heavy. I mean, it's probably about the same weight as a trolling motor and a battery, though. But it's just one unit, so it's a little different. But yeah, about to set this bad boy up. Let's see how it goes. This is the mount here. Just goes on the back of any flat tail canoe or John boat or whatever. I made a little mount here just to solidify the transom a little bit more and just thicken it up. It was too thin. I was maxing out the clamp. So I got the motor sitting here just warming up. So for my front end weight right now, I just got this 5-gallon container of water full. I really wish I had more. Last time I had my cooler up here, but I don't know, it was weird. It doesn't really fit up there too well. The water was shifting and it was making it so when I was leaning, it was all shifting. You really want something solid in there, because with water, as soon as the boat starts leaning, that water starts leaning, and it makes it even that much harder to overcorrect it. And yeah, this water's pretty cold for April. Probably about 50 degrees right now. All set up. I think I'm ready to go in the water. The tail is off the ground. Perfect. I actually like how it's got a little play in it. It's not super stout from the bungee cords. That's nice. Yeah, we're about to get in the water, see how this bad boy runs. motor's just coming over the back. It is not working. Yeah. And the more water it comes in, the heavier that I am getting back there, so. You know, people told me this might be sketchy on a canoe. I did not want to believe them. But I'm starting to think they were right. Well, I'm gonna drink a beer so I can use the can to scoop out some water. Get a little bit lighter in the back and then we'll retry. Did. Here's another one of them cement pylons. Boy, and I am just bottomed out on it. Jesus. That would not have been. What I about hit. Boy, I bet you that whole shaft would have just come off. That would have been bad news, but I don't know. That's what you run a mud motor, you run into them problems. Hit something. Not sure what. Yeah, I'd say overall, that's pretty sketchy, and I wouldn't recommend it. But it is damn fun, and in the summer, some shallow creek beds, sandy bottoms, I can see myself having a lot of fun on this canoe. But for now, I think I'm gonna put it on a 12-foot John boat, what it's meant to go on, because it's really just not worth it being out there. I mean, it's not comfortable because you can't have any of your gear in the back of the boat close to you. You're always on the verge of almost sinking. That's a better way to put it. So yeah, if you're gonna get a 212cc mudskipper kit, try to put it on your 16-foot canoe and see if it works out better than mine. It's weird because I've seen a whole lot of YouTube videos where people done this same exact thing and had them run fine. I don't know why mine runs so sketchy. It might just be because this canoe is made for a trolling motor. It's not really made for a lot of power on the back. It's just a Walmart WaterQuest square steering canoe. Well, I don't know. We'll keep playing with it. And yeah, I love this motor. It's sick. Happy Easter, y'all.